Roll call, please.
Born.
Here.
Baulk.
Here.
Bowers.
Excused.
Decker.
Here.
Gisha.
Here.
Hannah.
Here.
Heideman.
Here.
Koth.
Here.
Kittleson.
Here.
Kleunis.
Here.
Montemayor.
Here.
Rindfleisch.
Here.
Surik.
Here.
Vanderweel.
Here.
Vu.
Here.
And Wongeman.
Here.
15 present.
We have a quorum. Now, if Alderperson Montemayor can please lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Marilyn. Looking for approval of the minutes of the previous council meeting. President Morin.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move to approve the minutes from the last meeting.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion. No discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Resignations. Attorney McLean.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I have a resignation from Willie Scharer from the International Committee due to commitments that have suddenly and unexpectedly expanded.
For a motion from the floor, President Board.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move to accept and file the resignation.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion? No discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Mayor's appointments. Attorney McLean.
I hereby submit the following appointments for your confirmation to the Business Improvement District. Rick Scroggins, Mike Vandersteen, and Darren Bricko. Terms expiring 9/14/2012, signed by the mayor.
That lies over until the next meeting. Confirmation of mayor's appointments. Attorney McLean.
Henry Nelson to be considered for appointment to the Housing Rehabilitation Committee to fill the unexpired term of Aaron Gabriels, whose term expires 4/26/2010, signed by the mayor.
For a motion from the floor.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move to approve the appointment.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion. No discussion. May we have a roll call, please?
Born.
Aye.
Baulk.
Aye.
Decker.
Aye.
Gisha.
Aye.
Hannah.
Aye.
Heideman.
Aye.
Koth.
Aye.
Kittleson.
Aye.
Kleunis.
Aye.
Montemayor.
Aye.
Rindfleisch.
Aye.
Surik.
Aye.
Vanderweel.
Aye.
Vu.
Aye.
And Wongeman.
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. Election of the Board of Water Commissioners member. President Bourne.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move to open the floor for nominations for the Board of Water Commissioners.
Second.
And then we think we have to ask if there are any other nominations.
Are there any nominations from the floor? Vice President Gisha.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I nominate Art Stewart for the Board of Water Commissioners.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Are there any other nominations for the Board of Water Commissioners? Any other nominations? President Bourne?
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move that the nominations be closed and to cast a unanimous ballot for Art Stewart as the new Board of Water Commissioner.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to close nominations.
No, this would be to actually cast a unanimous ballot.
We have a motion and a second to cast a unanimous ballot for Mr. Art
Stewart
for the Board of Water Commissioners.
I'm doing all ayes.
All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Mr. Stewart, are you here?
Yes.
Congratulations, Mr. Stewart. Public forum. Sue?
Yes, our one this evening is Delcy Johnson. Dulcey, can I have your home address, please?
1306 North 3rd Street, Sheboygan.
And you will have 5 minutes.
Thank you. Mayor Ryan, members of the council, and citizens. Last week, I obtained a copy of the Fire Department Ambulance Service Financial and Activity Report for 2008. Some months ago, it was reported that the ambulance service made a profit of $406,188. This, of course, was computed using only marginal costs and does not reflect all the costs involved in providing this service. So in the interest of transparency, when one does a full cost analysis and figures personnel costs for 19 paramedics rather than just the 4 new hires, the profit becomes a deficit of $975,796. That figure is even larger when one considers that the information presented in the report does not include any administrative expenses, not one dime for training, although $2,000 was budgeted, and not one dime for the vehicle equipment lease, which was budgeted at $90,000. Adding the $92,000, one arrives at a deficit of over $1 million, and we still have not included any administrative costs. I haven't asked, so I do not know how startup costs are being accounted for or repaid, but would, I presume, be an additional expense adding to the deficit. And the deficit will grow even larger in 2009 when one considers, as discussed at the Finance Committee meeting on August 24th, that both runs and collections were down in the first 6 months of 2009. Personnel costs will grow by 10.5% in 2009 because of the pay and bonus increases. Paramedic firefighters received a 3% pay increase on January 1st, a 1.5% increase on July 1st, and up to 24 paramedics received a 3% bonus on January 1st and will receive an additional 3% bonus on December 31st for a total of 10.5%. Also of interest, I found, is the fact that overtime was 53% over budget and gasoline costs were 101% over budget. Runs and transports exceeded projections by 35%, which accounts for some of this overage. But you have heard me speak before about observing ambulances tooling around town and down by the lake, and I have spoken with numerous citizens on the north and south sides of town who have observed the same thing. Evidently, the ambulance drivers are not bothered by wasting gasoline, and they obviously also have time to waste. Neither Chief Lestusky nor any elected official is telling them to stop this practice, or they are not following orders. It is interesting to know that the City of Fond du Lac separates the costs involved in providing ambulance services from their fire department services. At the August 24th Finance Committee meeting, Alderman Boren stated that Fond du Lac figured a loss of $1.5 million for 2008. They attribute 50% of administrative costs to each service. 75% of paramedic firefighter personnel costs and 10% of all firefighter personnel costs are attributed to the ambulance service. One would hope that this council would choose to follow Fond du Lac's model, but unfortunately, I think that you prefer to see things through rose-colored glasses. Moving on to another topic. While I applaud the goals and objectives of the 2010 City of Sheboygan budget resolution, which will be discussed tomorrow evening at the Committee of the Whole, I am curious about one of the whereas clauses, specifically the one that reads, mid-year impact negotiations requesting the return of a 1.5% July 1st raise failed to get any labor support, thus putting the 2010 budget in further jeopardy. I have been told that the Public Works Union was willing to give up their July 1st 1.5% pay increase and agree to co-payments for their health insurance in an effort to prevent layoffs, but the city shut down and instead chose to lay off people. I was at the Salaries and Grievances Committee meeting on August 24th when the issue was raised, and a DPW spokesman said that a meeting scheduled for 5:30 that day had been canceled by the city. I emailed Alderman Bulk and Alderman Geisha on September 2nd, asking them if DPW had agreed to give up the 1.5% pay increase and agreed to co-payments on their health insurance.
Alderman Bauck responded on September 3rd that Alderman Geisha was not on the labor negotiations team, that I had received less than half the story, and that the issue was better explained over the phone. I am still waiting for Alderman Bauck to call me and explain the rest of the story, and so I wonder where the truth lies. The public has a right to know. Former Mayor Susha spoke a couple of weeks ago about the problems the SCTA...
Would you like an additional minute?
Please. Former Mayor Susha spoke a couple of weeks ago about the problems the SCTA was having in getting information. Alderman Bourne, Alderman Geisha, and Alderman Clayunas are always very thorough in answering my questions and concerns. But sometimes it seems that some elected representatives and department heads do not recognize the public's right to know. I am concerned when there seems to be an effort to withhold information to avoid, I believe, being subjected to further questions or criticism. Recently, I heard either the mayor or an alderman talk about the need for transparency. I hope that will be the reality going forward. Thank you.
Thank you. That's it.
Thank you again for speaking, Dulcie. Mayor's announcements. Sad note this evening, I'm sure we all recognize that Alderman Tom Bowers is not here this evening. He fell ill Saturday afternoon and went to a local hospital, at which time he was flown by Flight for Life down to Milwaukee. He did go through a medical procedure Saturday evening, and the prognosis is good, and according to Mrs. Bowers, she hopes he will be back in Sheboygan within days. So our thoughts and prayers are with him, and that is why he's not here this evening. So just think of Alderman Bowers. On a brighter note, this Friday, September 25th at 7:30 p.m., there is a benefit for the Wisconsin Naval Museum and Education Center of Sheboygan, which is going to be at the Weill Center. John McGivern is going to be doing his Neighborhood Tales show, which is entertaining to say the least. John McGivern's on WKLH usually a couple times a week, has been in numerous productions in Milwaukee and nationwide for that matter. Cost on this is $25, and it goes to benefit the future Naval Museum in Sheboygan. So if all of us can attend that, it would be a great thing to do. Begins at 7:30 p.m. at the Weill Center. You can prepay for tickets or buy them at the door if they are available. Normally his shows do sell out. So if people are interested in going, I believe I'll be there myself. That is this Friday, September 25th, 7:30 p.m. at the Weill Center. Should be a good show. So he's always entertaining. One of the funniest guys I've seen, so should be a good show. That's all I have for mayor's announcements. Consent agenda. We have 12-1 through 12-24. President Bourne?
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I make a motion to accept and file all our O's and accept and adopt all our C's and pass all ordinances and resolutions.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Under discussion, Alderman Bauck.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd ask that we deal with 1223 separately.
Okay, we're looking to deal with 1223 separately.
You want to do that first? Is it?
If we can then have, we have our motion for 12-1 through 1224, excluding 1223.
Sure.
Under discussion on those? No discussion. We do.
Mm-hmm.
Roll call.
Bauck.
Aye.
Decker.
Aye.
Geisha.
Aye.
Hannah.
Aye.
Heidemann.
Aye.
Koth.
Aye.
Kittleson.
Aye.
Clayunas.
Aye.
Aye. Rindfleisch.
Aye.
Surik.
Aye.
Vanderweel.
Aye.
Vu.
Aye.
Wongman.
Aye.
And Boren.
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. Now on 1223. Alderman Bauck.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just want to, under discussion, mention that it's not often a government-created body moves to shut itself down. So I'm really excited that the Water Safety Task Force did that as well. But I'm also very proud of the work that the Water Safety Task Force did while it was operating. Director Bittner, I want to give a huge shout out to Director Bittner, who did a great job of keeping the group focused and administering the task force. It was a thankless job that was sometimes like herding cats, but he kept us focused on the things we could do and not just the things we wish we could have done. As a news item, the variable message board is here and ready to be installed. Some of the other things that were done, there was signage that was put up both at the beach and as you approach the beach. There were 4 emergency phones put up to drive instant response to that should there have been another near-drowning incident. And there were countless rings put up at several locations along the beach on the north side and the south side. So those are some of the things. Things took a little longer than we expected. The variable message sign will be going in soon as we get into the late season, but it's high surfing season, so we have that to look forward to. Some of the successes are the combined efforts of the Sheboygan Fire Department, the Sheboygan Police Department, certainly the Public Works Department. The U.S. Coast Guard was involved at every meeting. Former lifeguards from the community, the surfing community was deeply involved in the production of the video and identifying the most dangerous points in town. The Park District people from that were involved. The sport fishing community, again, because they know the water so well along the coast. I'd like to again extend our thanks to the Jacobs and Ross Agency, who produced the 5-minute commercial that's been running around about water safety. And there were some concerned citizens that showed up from time to time to voice their concerns. So again, the Water Safety Task Force is recommending that it be dissolved because it's accomplished the goals it was challenged with. And I would suggest we pass this.
So we have a motion on 1223.
Motion to put it upon its passage. The RC.
We have a motion and a second on 1223. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? 1223 passed. Communications and petitions, 12-25, to be referred. Reports of officers 2, 12-26, by the city clerk. Submitting it as a matter of record in ecology directory, sharing earth-friendly happenings in Sheboygan and Sheboygan County regarding recycling and safe disposal, earth-friendly services, environmental projects, and community ecology wishes, compiled by Rich and Joyce Jordan. And we have a motion.
I move to accept and file.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion?
I'd just like to thank Rich and Joyce for this work. This was came out of the study group on the Natural Step, which is a book which the Sustainable Sheboygan Task Force also studied. And they were a secondary group that studied the book with John Hill as their teacher. And this is one of their dreams, was to produce this document to be used in the community as a resource. So I really appreciate their time and their dedication to this effort.
Thank you, Gene. President Bourne?
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I just want to second what Alderperson Clayunas mentioned, and also, would it be possible to get this on the city's website? Mm-hmm. Because this is really useful stuff.
We can do that.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jim. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 12-27 by the City Plan Commission recommending authorizing the sale of city-owned property at 1116 Huron Avenue, known as the Little Red Schoolhouse, with various conditions. Looking for a motion? Alderman Hannah.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would move that the resolution be put upon its passage.
Second.
And the... What do we have?
The RO
be accepted and filed.
Mm-hmm.
And the RO be accepted.
And the RO be accepted and filed.
We have a motion and a second under discussion. May I say, on the Little Red Schoolhouse, the city has owned this building for many, many, many years, and it's been vacant for many years. We did have a nonprofit group buy this building for our asking price, and they have also agreed that it is going to revert to the city tax rolls. So even though they are a nonprofit, they are going to be paying property taxes on it. So it's a good thing for the taxpayers. So, any further discussion? Attorney McLean?
Just for clarification, is the resolution, is that with the conditions that the Planning Commission is recommending
yes.
also?
Yes.
Okay.
Says with various conditions. Thank you, Attorney McLean. Any further discussion? You have a roll call, please.
Decker?
Aye.
Gisha?
Aye.
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
Aye.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
Aye.
Klayunis?
Aye.
Montemayor?
Aye.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wangaman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
And Bauck?
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-28. We are going to hold for 12-34. 12-29 through 12-33 will be referred. 12-34, resolutions introduced 3, 12-34. By Alderperson Kittleson, authorizing entering into a contract for the North 6th Street Flood Mitigation Project. Alderperson Kittleson.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to make a motion to suspend the rules on this. Because of the grant money that's involved, we need to keep this project going.
We have a motion to suspend, and we have a second under discussion on the suspension. No discussion? On the suspension only, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries to suspend the rules.
Okay, thank you. Then we'll need we're going to amend the resolution. However, we need a motion to put the resolution upon its passage first. So I'd ask for that motion, please.
We have a motion and a second to put the resolution upon its passage. Under discussion?
Under discussion, we are going to be amending this resolution because the project is being funded from two different funding sources. And if you need further explanation, I'd open the floor up to Chad Pelishek to explain what we are doing here.
Would anybody like...
Let's get the motion first.
To read the motion?
Yes. A motion to amend to...
We need to amend. Let me just get that out. Thank you.
We're amending 12-34.
Do you have it, Jane?
I do not.
I can read it if you want.
Thank you.
After the account number in the last paragraph, to add, in the amount of $293,489.63 and 2009 CDBG Entitlement Flood Mitigation Account Number, 209-33150-631500 in the amount of $97,829.88.
Everybody get that?
That's it. Everybody get the answer.
Thanks, Chad.
Okay.
Any discussion on the amendment? Would anybody like to hear an explanation from Chad Pelishek from nobody wants to hear Chad? Okay. Alderperson Klayunis.
Well, Chad can speak. I also wanted to just, this is the final stage of this whole project?
Correct.
It's paving the streets.
Right,
and,
right.
Okay.
No?
No,
yes.
this is a different project.
Oh, okay,
than,
that's why I was kind of...
Can we open the floor to Paulette Anders, please? Motion to do.
Was there a second on the amendment?
Did we have a second on the
you
amendment?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have a second on the amendment. Director Paulette Enders.
Thank you. What this is it's a grant that the city applied for. Chad Pelishek wrote the grant, and it was the flood monies when Sheboygan County was hit with the flooding. There was money that was available, and this North 6th Street is actually about 800 feet. It's a small section of North Street, just north of where we're working right now, and it's a completely separate project, but it ties into that flood mitigation that we're just wrapping up on 5th and 6th. So we're funding it in part with the money from the state. And then also we had to match locally, and we were able to use our CDBG entitlement to do that.
So we're basically state and federal money to do this project to correct the problems on 6th Street?
Yes.
Yes, and it's strictly timing why these two projects didn't go together. Unfortunately, we're just about to open up 6th Street two blocks down the road, and we're going to close it two blocks up the road. But we had to wait for the funding to come through. and the funding is just coming through now, so that's... And for a person that lives on 6th Street, you know, I feel your pain. So, thank you, Paulette. So we have a motion to...
Amend. That we need just an all eyes.
That we need, okay, on the motion to amend, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Passed as amended.
Now we need a motion.
Now we need a motion to pass the resolution.
The resolution as amended.
We need to ask for a motion to pass the resolution as amended, please.
Alderman Rindfleisch.
I ask that the Alderman add in, with the RO, deal with the RO as well.
Oh, yes, the RO 12-28.
Yes, add the RO 12-28 as well.
Okay, so we have a motion and a second to pass as the resolution and the RO as amended.
Okay.
Roll call, please.
Gisha?
Aye.
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
Aye.
Excuse me, Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
Aye.
Kleunis?
Aye.
Montemayor?
Aye.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
Aye.
Warren?
Aye.
Balk?
Aye.
And Decker?
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-35 through 12-37 lies over. To be referred, 12-38 through 12-45, and if we may note on 12-40, that is going to finance and also the Redevelopment Authority. So 12-40 also goes to the Redevelopment Authority. Reports of committees. Number 7, 12-46 by Law and Licensing, recommending denying beverage operator's license number 8364 based on his oral withdrawal of the license application. President Boren.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move that the report of committee be accepted and adopted.
Second.
Motion and a second. Under discussion?
Under discussion, Mayor, is Kevin M. Wade here tonight? He's not here, Mayor. Mr. Wade contacted me by telephone prior to our last law and licensing meeting and said that he was not going to appear as invited because he no longer needed the beverage operator's license, so we denied it based on his oral withdrawal for the license.
Very good. Any further discussion? Can we have a roll call, please?
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
Aye.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
Aye.
Kleunis?
Aye.
Montemayor? Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
Balk?
Aye.
Decker?
Aye.
And Gisha?
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-47 by Law and Licensing, recommending denying beverage operator's license number 8363 based on her record of violations related to the licensed activity and her status as an habitual law violator. President Boren.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move that the report of committee be accepted and adopted.
Second.
A motion and a second. Under discussion?
Under discussion, Mayor, is Tanya L. Niesing here tonight? She's not here, Mayor.
Very good.
Ms. Niesing appeared before our committee at our last meeting, and after listening to her comments, we recommended that the license be denied for the reasons that you just stated.
Any further discussion? No further discussion. May we have a roll call, please?
Heidemann?
Aye.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
Aye.
Kleunis?
Aye.
Montemayor?
Aye.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
Balk?
Aye.
Decker?
Aye.
Gisha?
Aye.
And Hannah?
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-48 by Law and Licensing, recommending denying beverage operator's license number 8358 based on his failure to include all relevant convictions on the application, his record of violations related to the licensed activity, and his status as an habitual law violator. President Boren.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move that the report of committee be accepted and adopted.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Under discussion?
Under discussion, Mayor, is Jeffrey J. Schutte here tonight? He's not here, Mayor.
Very good.
Mr. Schutte appeared before the committee at our last meeting, and after listening to his comments, the committee unanimously voted to deny the license based on the reasons you stated previously.
Any further discussion? No further discussion. Roll call, please.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson.
Aye.
Clayunis.
Aye.
Montemayor.
Aye.
Rinfleisch.
Aye.
Surick.
Aye.
Vanderweil.
Aye.
Vu.
Aye.
Wankaman.
Aye.
Boren.
Aye.
Bauck.
Aye.
Decker.
Aye.
Gisha.
Aye.
Hannah.
Aye.
And Heideman.
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-49 and 12-50 will be referred. Reports of committees. 8, 12-51 by finance, authoring a transfer of appropriations in the 2009 budget, establishing revenue and appropriation for donation received for police canine. Vice President Gisha.
Thank you, Your Honor. I move that the report of committee be accepted and adopted.
Second.
If I may, Your Honor. We had an individual who I'm not sure at this point whether it was anonymous or not anonymous, donate the money for not just the actual animal, but for the training of this animal, and to have the allow us to establish a second canine unit, which would be used for second and third shift. Right now, we got one person who gets called out all the time. That facilitated the need for a special vehicle. Canine vehicles are different, which had a price tag of about $24,000, I think. And we did not have that as a budgeted item. And I think Alderman Hannah has some words to say regarding that and how that was creatively handled by the chief and by the department.
Alderman Gisha, could you add the resolution to be passed also?
And I would also like to ask that the that the resolution be put upon its passage. Thank you.
We need a second.
We need a second on that?
Second.
We have a motion and a second and a
third.
Alderman Hannah?
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I just wanted to comment on a couple things. That the back in the days when I served on the school board, I know how effective the police dog was and what a welcome addition to the police force and how effective it was in both South and North High. And I just think it's wonderful. That officer and the canine were stretched pretty thin. And this really lets that second and third shift become much more effective. The police department led by Chief Eirich was creative in coming up with the budget dollars. I'm assuming it's an anonymous donor, but we want to thank the anonymous donor from Black River for being so generous in this donation.
And if I may add, this person, I don't think I would break his heart if I made him a not an anonymous donor. Basically, Fritz Rahmer, my counterpart in Black River, also known as the mayor of Black River, is the person that has generously donated this canine and the training to the citizens of Sheboygan. Fritz is very instrumental with the Neighbors Against Drugs program. You know, a lot of the billboards you see around town, et cetera, are courtesy of Fritz Rahmer. So if you see Fritz, thank him anonymously, I guess. So, but no, he does a lot for the cause, and he's a great man on top of it. So I thank Fritz, and I hope everybody else does too. Vice President Gisha?
Just to continue this thank you session, it is worthwhile to also note that Chief Eirich facilitated the entire cost of that vehicle through the remaining dollars from the DARE program, or is it the NAB program? One of those, yes. Was the DARE program. He had to go through channels and get approval from some county counterparts who held that money in trust. He facilitated that, so not only is the dog and the training and the new dog will be available to our citizens, but this vehicle that we described earlier will be 100% free to the taxpayers and the citizens thanks to his and his counterparts' efforts. So thank you.
And thank you, Chief Eirich. Any further discussion? No further discussion. Roll call, please.
Kittleson.
Aye.
Clayunis.
Aye.
Montemayor.
Aye.
Rinfleisch.
Aye.
Surick.
Aye.
Vanderweil.
Aye.
Vu.
Aye.
Wankaman.
Aye.
Boren.
Aye.
Bauck.
Aye.
Decker.
Aye.
Gisha.
Aye.
Hannah.
Aye.
Heideman.
Aye.
And Koth.
Aye.
15 ayes.
Motion carries. 12-52 by finance, recommending authorizing a transfer of appropriations in the 2009 budget, establishing revenue and appropriation for American Recovery and Reinvestment Act for transit buses and vehicles. Alderperson Montemayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I move to accept and adopt the RC and the resolution be put upon its passage.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Under discussion?
We're getting some stimulus money to Sheboygan. Thank you.
Thank you. Any further discussion? Vice President Kishin.
Thank you, Your Honor. My name was one of the ones originally on this and some companion documents. I wrote a letter to the Transit Commission and to this council and to Sue to remove my name from that document for some very specific reasons. We all understand that need for a transit system in the city of Sheboygan. I think it's also fairly clear at this juncture with riders and revenues and so forth that we need to take a look at how we deliver transit in Sheboygan. By adding these buses based on so-called free money would just perpetuate more of the same, and I think dilute the opportunity for us to take a look at a variety of different options within our transit department to deliver a higher quality of service to the taxpayers. I think the transit department is doing a lot with what they have. But the director, Transit Director McDonald, has been very clear that as funding diminishes, and it will, service diminishes. As service diminishes, ridership diminishes. The transit is not efficient for the riders as budgets shrink. Budgets have shrunk for transit for a number of years, leveled off for some, and the result is a service that is strangling itself based on the way they currently operate. I feel that by adding five more low floor, tall floor, whatever, they're the big buses, is a mistake. And I think we need an opportunity here to, and I'm hoping to use that opportunity to get the discussion started about the many different opportunities we have to deliver this service. Certainly, 20% of the transit budget only comes from the general fund of the city of Sheboygan, and therefore from the taxpayers directly from the city of Sheboygan. The rest comes from state and federal dollars. However, the part from the city is about $750,000. I think we can leverage that money, save money, and yet provide a better service. But by continuing to put more of the same out there, the opportunity goes away to do that. So I'm hoping that this is an opportunity for us to say, we need to look at this. I don't think anybody would disagree that we need to look at this, and we need to maybe put a little, not necessarily a line in the sand, but a challenge to the Transit Commission, of which I'm a member, to say, what are our other options to actually increase service? I'm not trying to stop a transit system. I don't think anybody else who will speak on this wishes to stop our transit service. We actually feel that by stopping this, it will maintain a transit system, because if we keep strangling the budget, it will be so incredibly inconvenient to get from one side of the city to the other at a cost of about $2 and take you about an hour that it will not be a viable option for anyone. Why would you want to use that? So I've had my name removed from this and the other companion items, and I will not be voting for it for that reason. The only other note I will make is that the $2 million is not $2 million. We have never paid dollar for dollar for a single city bus in the city of Sheboygan the entire history of the transit operation. What it is about a $400,000 gift, because we pay 20% of every bill with transit out of general fund revenues. So I find that to be a little, and it's not the Transit Commission's fault, it's state and federal fault, like to come in, ride on their horse in Sheboygan and say, look it, I got you $2 million. That's just a flat-out falsehood. And so to clarify that, and to clarify why my name would like to be off this document.
Thank you. And if I may add, you know, the dealing with transit and when we're dealing with state and federal money coming into transit, what the state and feds do is they match what we have. It's not that we match what they give us. It's not that if they give us $100, we match $200. It's if we have $200, they match $800. So for every dollar that we cut going into transit, mm-hmm. they cut, you know, for every $2, they cut $8. So it's kind of a double-edged sword out there on the whole thing, and it is self-perpetuating. But Alderman Hanna.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. And I too also hope that we'll take it as an opportunity to look at a better way to deliver transit, increase ridership. Because right now, the way we deliver it, I hear from constituents on this topic more than any topic, they see an awful lot of buses driving around with not a whole lot of passengers on there. And we need to figure out as a transit commission and as the management team at transit, a way to deliver a service that increases ridership, gets people to where they need to be in a more convenient time. And I just hope that this is kind of wake, because you're absolutely right, Mayor. It's a double-edged sword. It's free money with a catch. And at the same time, it's an unfunded mandate because you're on the hook for maintenance and you're on the hook for staffing. So I hope we use it as an opportunity to revisit how we're delivering the services.
Thank you, Alderman Hanna. Alderman Waterman.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I applaud Alderman Gish's stand on this. I think it's time that the council takes a long, hard look at the transit system and how we can better perform a more efficient job. And he certainly is correct that if we just keep funding new vehicles and keep on the same old path, we're never going to make a really more efficient system. And there's no doubt that we need a transit system in this city, but I doubt if there's an alderman or a person in this room who, as Alderman Hanna said, hasn't received complaints from people, and they say, how long is this going to continue that we send empty buses lumbering around the city? So I, too, will vote no on this document.
Thank you, Alderman Loggeman. Alderman Bout.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will join this conversation as well. It is, of the 2.5 years that I've been an alderman, it is the most consistent topic. Ambulances come and go, and all kinds of issues come and go. But this issue has been consistent, that people look at the buses, whether it's morning, noon, or night, I hear from joggers, I hear from bike riders, I hear from shift workers that are on the road at odd hours. I hear people that are on it at peak times, at 8 in the morning and 5 o'clock at night, and they say, what in the world are we doing with these multi-wheeled, ginormous buses with one person on them, and most of the time empty? And it seems like a balm to that to say, well, 80% of it's from the feds, so it's not quite as bad as it seems. And no, the truth is, it's as bad as it seems, because guess what? There's no such thing as free money. This money, this 80%, guess what? That's your money, too, that Washington is sending in. And if you pay any money to Madison, guess what? That's your money, too. And so the time has finally come, and I'm very pleased that Alderman Gish and Alderman Hanna are showing some leadership on this, that it's time to say stop. There's got to be a better solution. No one is saying we shouldn't have a vibrant transit system in this city. There's got to be a better way to get from point A to point B than waiting for a bus, getting on a bus, going to a hub in a small town like ours, waiting at that hub for the next bus, getting on a second bus and going to where you want to go, and then walk to your final destination. There's got to be a better way for that in a town of 50,000. Now, the people that ride the buses, I heard this when I was running for my first campaign, heard from the people who need the buses, they really need the buses. They have fewer options than anybody else. We need a transit system, but it is time for that transit system to be different than it's ever been before. And if we approve these 5 buses, there's no motivation for them to think differently. The system is uniquely designed right now to get the results it's currently getting. And if we want different results, we need a different system. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Alderman Bow. Alderperson Montemayor.
Thank you again, Mr. Mayor. This stimulus money, if you remember what the stimulus money is for, is to put people to work. So the factory that's manufacturing the buses, those people will be working. And we can receive the buses. Now, the money will be used at that factory to make those buses. We can receive the buses. That stimulus money is the money we paid for taxes. We can send our stimulus money that will come to us to some other community. I say we should bring it to Sheboygan.
Thank you, Alderperson Montemayor. Alderperson Kittleson, are you?
No, I didn't.
You know, one thing I think we need to look at here, without trying to sway opinion one way or the other, I don't disagree that we need to look at something different in the future. But the question is, if we do pass up this so-called opportunity here to receive 5 buses, Are we ready? Are we prepared infrastructurally? Are we prepared basically monetarily to take that alternative route? And I think we have to ask each other, you know, ask that of everybody has to ask that of themselves. If we do pass up this opportunity to receive five buses, are we prepared to have the answer? That's all I'll have to say. Alderperson Clayunas.
Thank you, Mayor. I agree with what you said, and I think if we buy these buses, they can be traded in. If we have a marvelous new plan that can serve the city better, these buses will be useful as a trade-in to other cities that have need of large buses. I've been told that transit is running buses that are really way beyond their life, and that if we don't get them replaced, we'll have nothing very soon, or buses breaking down on their routes. So in the name of people who use the buses, I'm very excited if we can have a new plan. I just hope that the men who are on this committee will work at that and give us some suggestions, and I'd be very happy to hear them. But at this point, I think the need is there, and for the sake of citizens who have no choice, I'm going to vote yes.
Thank you, Alderperson Clayunas. Any further discussion? No further discussion. Roll call, please.
Clayunas?
Aye.
I'm sorry, do you all know what you're voting?
An aye means we're going to take the free buses. Yes.
The aye means we, yes. Okay.
Aye.
Thank you. Montemayor?
Aye.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
No.
Boren?
No.
Bauk?
No.
Decker?
No.
Gisha?
No.
Hannah?
No.
Heidemann?
No.
Koth?
Aye.
And Kittleson?
Aye.
8 ayes, 7 noes.
Motion carries. Attorney McLean?
Yes, this document is a budget transfer resolution that requires a two-thirds vote.
Oh, it requires two-thirds vote. Motion fails.
Yep.
Thank you. Moving on, 12-53.
This is a point of order, Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
For the attorney. And that would be two-thirds of the 16, right? Not just who happens to be here, or is it just two-thirds?
Pretty sure it's two-thirds.
Of I think two-thirds of the...
I just think it is.
Regardless, two-thirds of all the members.
Motion still fails. 12-53. By finance, recommending authorizing entering into contract for the purchase. Is this what the one I just went through?
No, this is the companion.
Okay, this is the companion document. By finance, recommending authorizing entering into contract for the purchase of 5 low-floor buses, along with miscellaneous equipment and parts, 100% funded through the AARRA.
Move to file.
Second.
We have a motion to file and a second. Under discussion. A roll call, please.
Montemayor?
No.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
I'm sorry.
Aye.
Thank you. Surik?
No.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
Bauk?
Aye.
Decker?
Aye.
Gisha?
Aye.
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
Aye.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
No.
Clayunas?
No.
11 ayes, 4 noes.
Motion to file carries. Matters laid over. 11-44. Resolution number 71-09-10 by Alderperson Kittleson, authorizing entering into contract for the purchase of construction equipment, including 2 articulated wheel loaders, less trade, and 1 rubber tire excavator, less trade, for the motor vehicle division. Alderperson Kittleson.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to ask for a motion to put the resolution upon its passage, please.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion?
Under discussion, you can see that the funding for the above items are included in the 2009 budget, and the equipment to be replaced and traded requires repairs exceeding $56,000, and the economic conditions have resulted in the receipt of bids that are considerably less than the budgeted amount. So it's a good thing to do.
Thank you, Alderperson Kittleson.
Thank you.
President Bourne?
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I would like to ask Mr. Bittner a question, if he could step forward on this. Bill, I was wondering if you could tell me if the department was to spend the $56,000 for repair, how much useful life that would give the equipment in lieu of purchase?
The numbers that were quoted here come from our maintenance department, and they're things that the department is aware that needs to be fixed on this equipment. The equipment, as if you think more in terms of an old junker car, it's not fixed because you fixed what's broke. It's still, in some cases, a 17-year-old or a 15-year-old piece of equipment. And this is not, the numbers that are here are not a refurbishing of that piece of equipment. It's just things we know that have to be replaced at the current time. So I'm not sure I could suggest that trying to refurbish this equipment or try to simply repair this equipment is a wise investment. There are times in heavy equipment like this when you see equipment in the 8, 9, 10-year-old range that makes a lot of sense to say give it a rehab, go through everything and, you know, spend $20,000-$30,000. I don't think any of these three pieces are at that.
And can I ask, Bill, how often are these pieces of equipment used? Are these used summertime and wintertime?
This is the front end loaders are our primary piece. They're major snow equipment and they're major construction. They move material. That's moving salt, moving asphalt if we want to pave. It's moving dirt if we want to build a road. And the backhoe, or what we call the excavator, is what you dig with. So any repairs you do on the street is done with an excavator. So these are what you call bread and butter pieces for us.
Thank you. Any further questions for Director Bittner? Thanks, Bill. We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? No further discussion. Roll call, please.
Rindfleisch?
Aye.
Surik?
Aye.
Vanderweel?
Aye.
Vu?
Aye.
Wongeman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
Bauk?
Aye.
Decker?
No.
Gisha?
Aye.
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
No.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
Aye.
Kleunis?
Aye.
And Montemayor?
Aye.
13 ayes, 2 noes.
Motion carries. 11-35, RO number 186-09-10, by the purchasing agent submitting bids for the purchase of one motor vehicle division rubber tire excavator, less trade. Alderperson Kittleson.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd make a motion to put the resolution.
The RO.
The RO.
Just file it. Accept and file.
To file the RO.
Accept and file.
To accept and file the RO.
Second.
We have a motion and a second under discussion. Alderman Rindfleisch.
For sake of time, I ask we take 11:36 at the same time.
Oh, yes.
Okay, we'll take 11:36 with 11:35 if nobody disagrees. Under discussion, any discussion? Roll call, please.
We can do an all ayes on these.
No. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 11-58. General Ordinance number 15-09-10 by Alderman Boren, amending Section 2-112 of the Municipal Code so as to change the date of the first regular meeting of the Common Council in October 2009 from the first Monday to the first Tuesday of the month. President Boren.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. I move that the ordinance be put upon its passage.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Under discussion. Have Alderperson Montemayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Well, I was told that we want to do this because of the football game. So needless to say, I said, I can't believe it. I mean, we do this for federal holidays, that's true. But we haven't done it for the Olympics or a Pope's funeral or an inauguration. I can't imagine we're going to do this for a football game. I mean, social engagements are important, that's true. And certainly, people can, if they have the tickets to that football game, go ahead and go. But I can't imagine that we would change a council meeting for that. And Alderman, I mean, Attorney McLean, this doesn't involve a charter ordinance change, does it?
No, it's not a charter ordinance. It's a general ordinance change that it's up to the council. Okay,
thank you.
Thank you, Alderperson Montemayor. Alderperson Clayunas.
Just a question. Do the Packers always play on the first Monday in October on Monday Night Football? Is that why this is also
no,
this
they
particular
don't.
Day?
This is strictly, I believe, list for this year, in October 2009, changing it for this year, not for October 2010. And the Packers don't normally, I shouldn't say don't normally, but wouldn't usually play in the first Monday in October, and they wouldn't usually play Brett Favre and the Minnesota Vikings on the first Monday in October. That would happen to fall on a council night. So, you know, the question is this a social engagement, or is this, you know, part of the fabric of our society that we would actually postpone a very important council meeting by 24 hours in order to watch the Green Bay Packers? And that's the question we have to ask ourselves. Alderman Rindfleisch.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will be definitely using my DVD recorder for the game, and hopefully no one gives me the answer. But I've been saying that we do need to take our responsibilities as a council seriously, both following rules of decorum within the council, towards relationships, towards working with each other, how we talk to each other, not what we do. Also, though, it is a serious work that we do here, and I will not be voting to move for the Packer game, even though it's going to kill me. No, the game is not at the same time. But I think it's far more important that we follow, you know, the standards that our forefathers have set and who've sitting in this council chamber. I don't think they would have moved it for something like that as well. So no, I will not be supporting it.
And if we have earplugs and blinders, maybe we won't know who's ahead by the time we start watching it. Any further discussion? President Board.
Thank you, Mayor Ryan. It's been said that the council meetings have better ratings than Monday Night Football. And this meeting that we are going to have the first week of October, whether it be on Monday or Tuesday, just so happens that it is going to be a very important meeting, because what is going to come out of the Committee of the Whole tomorrow night is our discussion on how we move forward with the 2010 budget. And speaking about transparency, I think it's going to be a very important discussion on whether we have it on Monday or Tuesday night. I would like to see as many people watch this on Tuesday night. This is a very important discussion that we're going to have on this budget for 2010. And also, I think there possibly will be a few more people here to speak at the public forum on possibly giving the council its marching orders or some suggestions for the 2010 budget. So for that reason, I think it's a wise decision to hold it off one night. It's not going to be the end of the world that we postpone it one night and have it on that Tuesday night for those reasons. Thank you.
Thank you, President Board. Alderman Baum.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd just like to know if Dulcie's a football fan, and if she's a football fan, I want to have the meeting Monday night.
Thank you, Alderman Bauck. Alderperson Montemayor.
Thank you again, Mr. Mayor. I think lots of people should be here for the first meeting in October, yes. And by the way, Packers do play on Monday nights often. That over the years, that has happened quite often. If it's on Tuesday night, I'll need to be excused because I scheduled to teach a class on a night that I did not have a municipal duty. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you, Alderperson Montemayor. Alderperson Kittleson.
Thank you, Mayor. And just to add to that, I believe if people are, you know, are going to be absent from the meeting, we do have an order of things here in the council that people are able to conduct meetings and conduct our business with, you know, with those of us who are here. So that's my comment.
Very good. Any further discussion? Shall we do a roll call? Let's do a roll call on that, please.
No, let's just do an, no.
No, let's do a roll call on this.
Yeah. And everybody know what we're voting on? I vote will be to change it. Okay. Sirk.
Aye.
Excuse me?
I got a real secure eye.
I need clear voices here. Come on. Was it an aye?
Yes, it was.
Thank you. Vanderweel?
No.
Vu?
No.
Wangaman?
Aye.
Boren?
Aye.
Bauck?
No.
Decker?
Aye.
Gisha?
Aye.
Hannah?
Aye.
Heidemann?
Aye.
Koth?
Aye.
Kittleson?
No.
Kalyunas?
No.
Montemayor?
No.
Rindfleisch?
No. Uh-oh. Does it require two-thirds?
No.
Eight to seven.
8-7 on the eyes?
I'm changing.
The eyes have it then.
You will excuse me for that Tuesday.
And Alder Person Montemayor is excused on Tuesday. Anybody else want to be excused right away? All right, we're good. The ayes have it. Motion carries. Other matters authorized by law, 12-54, an RO by the city clerk submitting a communication as a matter of records from the Public Service Commission of Wisconsin regarding the 715 and 920 area codes that are expected to exhaust within the next 2 to 3 years and what possible solutions are being investigated.
Motion to file.
Second.
We have a motion to file and a second. Under discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 12-55 through 12-57 to be referred. Any other matters authorized by law? Attorney McLean, do we have
12-58
anything?
12-58 is an RO by the city clerk submitting various license applications for the period ending June 30, 2010 and June 30, 2011.
And that, is that, does that lie over?
Law and licensing.
Oh, that's to be referred to law and licensing.
Motion to adjourn.
We have a motion to adjourn.
Second.
And a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned.